so good to be back home again. San Francisco is home for me, and so happy to be with the product community that we started building together 12 years ago. There weren't that many people, let me tell you that. So let's talk about how product teams, or the winning product teams, are being transformed from being AI curious into AI first. I don't have very good news for you today, because 93% of AI transformations are failing today. That's a huge number. Let me put this in a different context. $200 billion are being invested by companies to try to make AI work for them. But more than $180 billion of that will deliver no meaningful impact. BCG found just 7% of companies report significant AI gains, while the MIT found that 95% of AI pilots fail to move the P&L needle. Those are different studies with a very similar takeaway. AI adoption doesn't necessarily translate into AI impact automatically. That $200 billion figure that I just showed only represents the investments companies are making this year in software and services. For example, AI tools, training services, implementation services. This is excluding investments that hyperscalers are making on infrastructure and the model layer. This is not just bad. It's the worst success rate of any digital transformation in 25 years. We've been through the internet era, mobile and cloud, agile, product-led growth most recently, and they were really, really poorly executed. But if you now compare to AI, it looks great. Most companies focus on tools, not transformation. AI transformation is not failing because of tools or even the adoption of such tools. Real transformation comes from orchestrating people, tools, and processes into a new operating system. Let me say this again. The real transformation comes from orchestrating people, tools, and processes into a new operating system. So we're going to play a game. I would love to learn from you what you think is the main reason why AI transformations are failing. I already gave you one that is not the reason, which is AI tools. I'm going to give you three options. Number one is lack of executive commitment. Number two is lack of workforce AI fluency. And number three is legacy systems and lack of data hygiene. So the way we're going to play this game is, to the count of three, I just want everybody in this room to raise your hand and give me one, two, or three fingers, depending on what you think the right answer is. Okay, ready? Let's go. One, two, three. What do you think? I see a lot of everything, but I would say mostly threes, I would say. Well, I have personally good news to share with you, which is you're all winners. All of the above are the three most important reasons why AI transformations are not delivering yet. However, lack of executive commitment is the first bottleneck, so option number one. When leadership isn't aligned, teams don't get enabled. When the teams aren't enabled, operating systems stay outdated, stay the same. So ultimately, the trust goes down and nothing happens, no change. So let me unpack each of those three problems that I just mentioned and see exactly what is really going on. So on the first one, the lack of executive commitment, it is crazy that only 8% of business leaders today consider themselves fluent in AI. Most executives delegate AI to the teams, or even worse, they hire a peer chief AI officer to kind of handle the situation. But that doesn't work, because executives have to walk the talk, not just even sponsor the talk. This is not about support, it's about commitment. In this case, executives must become advanced AI users first. The second one is around the lack of workforce AI fluency. This is another incredible irony. AI fluency is now the fastest growing skill in the world. Fastest growing skill in the world. However, according to BCG, 58% of companies investing in AI tools have no upskilling plan. So they're basically buying tools right and left and telling people, well, go and play with AI. So when AI is treated just like a sandbox experiment, it never really scales beyond the champions. It should be the other way around. First, build a structured upskilling plan, and of course, equip the teams with the right tools so they can apply what they've learned. But there has to be a regional structure. And lastly, when I talk about legacy systems and data hygiene, which is something that a lot of people here resonated with, the problem is that most companies are just trying to layer AI on top of the outdated systems with messy data. So that sounds like the easy way to start, because you don't really have to open the box. But you have to open the box instead of just investing and provide the right context for those models and those tools to actually work for you. So when data's unreliable, the insights are unreliable. Employees stop trusting the outputs and eventually default to just sprinkling a little bit of AI on top of their old workflows, which, of course, we know the outcome of that. Winning companies, the ones who are in that 7%, they are rebuilding their workflows around AI to consider how information moves across teams, how data is governed, as well as how humans collaborate with agents. So enough talking about problems. Now it's time to also cover what is the solution and like what is it, where we are in this adoption curve. This is the four stages of AI maturity for enterprises. Stage number one is experimentation. This is the, okay, here's the tool, go play, break things, move fast, have some fun. Unfortunately, most companies are still there. And don't get me wrong, it's important, it's better than stage number zero. I don't think adoption is the issue at this point. We are all understanding the need, and we've all played with many different AI tools. It's just what is next. So stage number two is what I call use case automation. The focus here is cost savings. That's usually the most intuitive outcome for companies as they start gaining some value out of this AI. Stage number three is what I call systems integration. Here we evolve from just pure cost savings into user value, into finding ways to not just increase the margin, but to actually delight the customer. And stage number four is AI first transformation. Here we go beyond just user value into business value and new growth models. For context, only 1% of companies today consider themselves to be in stage number four. Just to put things in perspective. Sometimes we live in San Francisco and we think that everybody's kind of stage four. It's not the case. But I lied, because there's stage number five, and that's what I call AI native. AI native are companies that were mostly born in the AI era and haven't reached the size of large enterprises yet. So they don't have legacy systems to fix or workflows to redesign, because they started using AI from day one. Think of companies like OpenAI, Anthropic, or even Lovable, you just heard from. But for most companies, including mine, Product School, we weren't born AI native. We had to transform. That's why the first goal is to become AI first. And AI first means defaulting to the AI as the first response to solve problems and build products. That's exactly what we had to do at Product School. We became AI first ourselves so we could be in a position to help others do the same. And this wasn't easy. Even though we're not a large enterprise yet, it took me almost 2 years to get this one right. So what I'm going to share with you is like probably my three biggest mistakes throughout this journey and how I use them as a way to turn it around. In 2023, we actually launched the first ever AI certification for product. And that was a huge success. Like, it took off. I mean, it doesn't take a genius, right? Like, product managers everywhere wanted to learn how to better use AI. So we kind of capitalized on that. We were the first movers. We have the largest product community. And we just put this into market, and it worked. The irony is that inside Product School, we weren't AI first yet. Our product team was thriving, but other teams such as marketing, ops, or sales, they were lagging behind. We were teaching AI externally, but not living it internally. So we made the decision, I made the decision, to become our own customer again. And what I mean by that is that this is not just for my product teams. We started training everybody in the company on AI, even teams that are not product, such as marketing, sales, or ops, actually took our AI for product certification. Because this was absolutely table stakes for us to use AI fluency as the new baseline. So that was number one.
The second big mistake that I made was delegate AI too early. It's funny because as I give this presentation, I'm like, I'm sharing best practices and I didn't follow any of them. So I love this stuff, but I think I miscalculated the impact that AI was going to have and the effort that it would take to actually transform. So I saw my engineers, they seemed to know what they were doing. I was like, okay, cool, take it from here, you know? And I kind of assumed that because they were using AI, this was good enough. Externally, of course, we partner with a lot of AI product leaders. You're going to meet many of them here today. So it was also easy for me to delegate to them and be like, great, go and start teaching our AI programs to all of our customers. But while it seemed efficient, I was so wrong. Transformation can't be outsourced. It has to be modeled. So I had to go back to my own product roots and start building with AI again. That was huge for me because I definitely learned how to drink my own champagne. I also took my own certifications. But it also sent the right message, starting with the leadership team. It's not just me, it's us. And this is everyone's responsibility. We're not hiding the chief of AI. We are all chiefs of AI. So we're going to start building, rolling up sleeves, no excuses. I don't care what function you're reading, you are building with AI. That also helped me flatten the org and continue sending the right message to other people, managers, and maybe weren't part of the leadership team. We actually removed a lot of layers and made sure that every single people manager was treated as a player coach. Everybody's building, no excuses. And we're building daily. We also introduced hiring constraints where we defaulted to justifying why AI wouldn't be able to do what we needed a human to do, while we didn't reduce expectations. So that constraint creation really helped people become even more creative across all levels. And then of course, when it was necessary to hire, we introduced AI fluency as an absolutely necessary requirement. That was my learning. And here's the third mistake around AI adoption. I'm good at inspiration. So I did all the classic things. I send the AI memo to the team talking about the world is changing and we are the best. I also created space during the all hands meetings for people to showcase some of the things that they were using with AI and kind of build some momentum around it. I even created a hackathon with some of my champions to try to push this a little further. People were definitely using AI and loving it. That's why I don't say that adoption was the problem. I just realized that inspiration without measurement is just a sugar high. And thank God I actually didn't do this, but I'm now seeing many companies doing it, which is adding AI adoption as a criteria in performance reviews. You can gain the system. And first of all, people are adopting tools for the most part, but even if they're not, they can still say they are. So unless you really have a sophisticated system, AI adoption is just a small leading indicator, not really the actual bottleneck. So we also had to continue pushing this because clearly just inspiring people and making it fun wasn't going to be enough. We typically refresh our strategy by the end of each year. This time was different. We revamped our whole three-year strategy from the ground up and made sure to introduce AI as the number one priority. Even though it still felt not urgent in some cases, we made a point to really, really prioritize that and then break it down to very specific AI-related OKRs that now I'm reviewing with my leadership team every single week. No matter what other fires we need to put out, no matter what other things we need to cover, AI is critical for us. And I think where I put the energy, where as a leader you put the energy flows, you put the attention, the energy flows for everybody else. So in summary, these were my three biggest mistakes that I turned into learnings. I stopped chasing adoption and started driving impact. I stopped delegating and started leading from the trenches. And I stopped just inspiring and started systematizing. That's how our product school became AI first. And that's why we're now in a position to help others do the same. Not as consultants, but as practitioners who've gone through the same journey ourselves. After 12 years leading Product School, I'm generally excited to announce our next chapter. This is not just a regular product launch. This is refounding the company. Our vision stays the same, which is to elevate the craft of product management. But our mission has evolved, which is now to become the global leader in AI training for product teams. This next chapter begins with three new AI training programs. Check them out. We are all in on AI. We just launched these three new AI certifications because they're focused on critical skill gaps in today's product organizations. First one is AI prototyping. Learn to generate high fidelity prototypes with AI to test ideas faster and de risk major investments. Number two is AI evals. Build evaluation pipelines for non-deterministic AI systems so your teams can deploy with confidence. And third, advanced AI agents. Design and orchestrate multi-agent systems that reason, collaborate, and automate complex workflows. We also upgraded our five existing programs to make them fully AI native. And this is not about adding a module on AI kind of on the side as a bonus. This is about infusing AI into the DNA of how product teams are building across the entire lifecycle. And as a sneak peek, next month we'll be adding another AI native certification titled AI Strategy for Product Leaders. Now, I understand every transformation is different. So when we start working with a new client, we start with our proprietary AI maturity assessment. This will help us pinpoint your current state of AI maturity, product capabilities, identify the biggest opportunities for impact, and map the fastest path to measurable value. From there, we co-design and create an upskilling plan, define the clear success criteria, and tailor the right programs and cohort composition for each team. In short, we help companies orchestrate people, tools, and processes into a new operating model built for the AI era. Now, every single time we introduce change, I like to clarify what's not changing. What are our non-negotiables? No matter how many other things we decide to introduce in the future, these are my commitments to you. Even in the AI era, our trainings will continue to be human-led and delivered live. All of our instructors are top product leaders working at some of the best companies in Silicon Valley. They've been there, they've done that. They are not teachers. The second piece is around the level of tailoring that it takes to really do a fantastic job for each client. We design each engagement for your specific product context and AI maturity level. And lastly, we commit to keeping small cohorts where the magic happens. There is high levels of interaction and personalized coaching for everybody to really change or translate all of these new skills into new behaviors. This is just a sample of some of the clients that we serve. We're very proud to serve many Fortune 500 clients across industries such as financial services, healthcare, and telecom. If you are also serious about helping your team maximize the real business impact of AI, we're here to help every step of the way. And I know that usually taking that first step can be hard. So I want to offer a free AI transformation workshop led by one of our product leaders just for your team. Market value of this program is $10,000. But I want to offer the first 10 AI transformation workshops for people in this room for free. If you're interested, scan this QR code or go to the website productschool.com/enterprise and my team will reach out. Thank you very much.